everyone. Welcome to While Waiting series. Thank you for watching this next preparatory video towards our upcoming 7-day cell deliverance prayer session starting from November 29th and running to the 5th of December 2021. Okay, please stay tuned. I'll be right back. I have something very, very interesting coming up. It's our 7-day cell deliverance prayers for this year 2021. The Word of God is powerful, active, effective, operative, and is sharper than any two-edged sword. The Word of God will sort out any situation. Then I'd like to invite you to join me from the 29th of November 2021 all through to the 5th of December 2021 for 7 amazing days of teaching the Word, studying the Word, and praying together. It's our annual 7-day self-deliverance prayers, and it promises to be an amazing one. Please see the link below, register, and see you on the 29th of November. Thank you. Welcome back. I'd like to say a big thank you to everyone who have registered. If you are yet to register, please register. It will give us the opportunity to get your details and be able to send you emails, you know, and other correspondence as we go through this program. Today, I'd like to talk about the power of expectation. The power of expectation. I said something in one of the videos. I said, please show up for the 7-day self-deliverance prayer sessions, but don't just show up, show up. Now, the second showing up means show up with excitement, show up with faith, show up with high hopes, show up with positive expectations. You know, for everyone who got miracles from the Bible, from our Lord Jesus Christ, they came with faith. Even though that they were not sure, they came expectant. Now, what is expectation? What's the definition? So I checked it up. And expectation simply means a strong belief that something will happen. All right, or something will be the case. A strong belief that something will happen. Simply put, come into the 7-day self-deliverance prayers with the belief that God will hear me. God has, it's my turn. I'm not ending this year with this oppression. This sex in the dream will end. All the affliction will stop. That's simply expectation. And how do you build it? All right. It simply starts by meditating on positive things and becoming Philippians 4. Living out, working out Philippians 4:8. Philippians 4:8 says, the NLT says, and now, dear brothers and sisters, one final thing. Fix your thoughts on what is pure. Can you say that? Fix. That means station your thoughts on what is pure and honorable and right and pure and lovely and admirable. Think about things that are excellent and worthy of praise. So that's how we start. Begin to think and picture your victory. Don't come in with fear, defeat. I know you've prayed. I know you've been on this journey. I've done it before. Fikayo, I'm not sure this would work. What makes this different? What's so special about this? And I'd like to quickly read a few stories. Three people from the scriptures that has consistently been a blessing to me. These three people had expectations. Yes, they might have had doubt at the back of their mind, but they allowed their expectation to push them forward to attaining their miracle. Let's talk about the woman with the issue of blood. Now, the Matthew, Luke, Mark has different, you know, versions of the story, but I'm going to pick the Mark version. So Mark chapter 5 verses 25, and I'll quickly read. A woman in the crowd has suffered for 12 years with constant bleeding. Verses 26 says she had suffered a great deal from many doctors, and over the years she has spent everything she had to pay them, but she had gotten no better. Does that sound like anyone? I know it might. Let's go on. In fact, she had gotten worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him through the crowd and touched his robe. For she thought to herself, if I can touch the hem of his garment, I will be healed. Immediately, the bleeding stopped and she could feel in her body that she had been healed of her terrible condition. Now, take note of a few points there. Number one, she had done all. She had gotten worse. There was no solution. So that could be what you've been through. You've prayed. You've done all you know to do, but there seemed to be no way out. Glory to God. The Word of God is the way out. And you have come into that season in Jesus' name. The Bible says she thought to herself, verses 28. She thought, just merely thinking about it. Referring back to Philippians 4:8, she thought to herself, if I can touch the hem of his garment, I will be healed. Merely thinking and acting, she got her miracle. Glory to God. Another beautiful story can be found in Mark 10, the story of blind Bartimaeus. Mark 10:47 says, when Bartimaeus heard that Jesus of Nazareth was nearby, he began to shout, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. "Be quiet," many of the people yelled at him, but he only shouted louder, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Verses 49 says, when Jesus heard him, he stopped. His expectation, his faith action caused Jesus to stop, and Jesus said, "Tell him to come here. Tell him to come here." So he called the So the people telling him to stop, they were the ones that beckoned on him that Jesus is calling you. Glory to God. I love that part. So they called the blind man, "Cheer up," they said, "come on, he's calling you." Can you imagine? The people telling him to stop are the people that went back to tell him, "Cheer up, he's calling you." So don't let anything hold you back from expressing your expectation. Bartimaeus threw aside his coat, jumped up and came to Jesus. "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus asked. "Rabbi," the man said, "I want to see." "Go, your faith has healed you," Jesus said. Instantly the man could see and he followed Jesus down the road. Do you see that? Beautiful story. He was screaming and yelling while everybody told him, "Shut up, you're making too much noise." You might feel the same way. Hey, I've been doing this. It's time to stretch. It's time to still do what you've done before, maybe, or do things differently as the Holy Spirit will lead you. But you must express your expectation. It's very important. Expectation shows faith. Expectation shows faith. No matter what you feel, you must come into this season in faith. And finally, Matthew 8. This is one story that, as in, I am always amazed. Each time I look at Matthew 8, verses 8, the story of the Roman officer. I'll just read verses 8. The Roman officer said, "Lord, I am not worthy to have you come to my home, but just say the word from where you are and my servant will be healed." Amazing. Jesus, don't come to my home. Are not worthy to receive. Just speak from where you are. That's expectation. You must look forward to your miracles. You must look forward to Jesus coming through for you. You must look forward to getting rid of the spirit husband, spirit wife. You must look forward to getting your life back. You must look forward to rebuilding your marriages. If you are here under the sound of my voice, you are married and you have been going through this spirit husband, spirit wife oppression, it is time to break free. God's plan for you are good and not evil. This is the devil afflicting your home, afflicting your life. It's time to put a hold to it. Remember, Christ has delivered you from the power of darkness. Christ has translated you from the power of darkness to the kingdom of his dear son. It's time for you to stand up and take hold of what is rightfully yours. Stop being dormant about what the devil is doing. Rise up in faith. Let your expectation come alive. How do you ignite expectation? Studying the word. Remember, I said Ephesians, Colossians, Philippians, Thessalonians. Why am I asking you to study so much? So that your faith can come alive. If you can jump to Mark, Matthew, Luke, if you just keep studying the word to build and boost your faith. You know the beautiful thing about studying the word? No matter the part of the Bible you read, your faith will come alive. No matter the part, go and read Proverbs, your faith will come alive. Read Deuteronomy, your faith will come alive. So we must take time to dive into the word, to build hope, ignite faith, and be able to address everything that needs to be addressed. All that you have to do is all I've said, and many more the Holy Spirit will reveal to you. Thank you for watching this video, and I'm looking forward. I'm so expectant, I'm so excited at what God is about to do for you, in you, and with you. Thank you for watching this video and see you on the 29th of November. God bless you.